Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. So in this video, this is a kind of a hard topic for me, so I might, not hard topic in per se of like, it's hard for me to talk about this, but it's hard in kind of articulating my kind of experiences and my observations. I'm gonna be careful not to really offend anyone or anyone being like specifically my former coworkers, because this video is about the attitudes that I've noticed. Kind of the pattern of our attitudes shifts from here and there, even my own. You know, because a lot of people that work in a homeless shelter previously didn't, or they were in kind of a different field or something like that, and I know I didn't. That was my first experience, and I've only been there for a year. I don't know if my views of the homeless has changed that much. I mean, certain aspects of it did. I've actually come out of that work experience like not learning as much as I expected to learn, or you know, coming to experience as much as I would thought to expect, because it was a shelter serving, was a huge shelter. First of all, it's 200 homeless clients in one building, and almost all of them are diagnosed with a mental illness and or a chemical addiction. So they're former drug addicts. Some were ex-convicts. Some like have serious schizophrenia issues. You know, it's a MICA shelter with 200 people in one building. So I went into it kind of thinking like, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna come out of this like having so many amazing experiences. I'm gonna learn so much about the homeless people that I'm serving. I'm going to have such an incredible different outlook about them. I come out after a year of working and not really, not as much as I expected. I mean, that's not to say that I didn't learn and didn't experience a lot. There's certainly a lot to share with this, as long as I maintain my confidentiality, which I think I am. But that's another thing. But then I've seen also a pattern in my with the attitudes shifting back and forth with my former coworkers. And this is really, I don't mean to like say anything negative about them. It's just something I've noticed, you know, kind of, it's, I think the misassumptions we have when we become a worker of a shelter is because we, as a worker, see so much of these people that are homeless that we now come to have a judgment on them. So instead of becoming more accepting and more sympathetic and more empathetic about the homeless, as a worker, I've seen us actually become more judgmental of the homeless population. And it's been an interesting thing to observe happen. And I think one of the main reasons that happens is because we are with them so much, yet we're always kind of in this as an observer. You know, we're there to keep the peace. We're there to kind of serve the clients like, oh yeah, this guy needs a toothbrush, here you go. This guy needs to go to this case manager here, I will escort him. This guy needs to be scheduled for this. It's always in a matter of service, and it's always a matter of observing like, oh my gosh, this guy is about to get into a fight, let's stop that from happening. This guy is like doing drugs in the bathroom, let's kind of, you know, handle that situation. So because the worker is always either handling a situation with the homeless person or serving the homeless the person something, and when that person needs something, or when nothing's going on, we're just watching, hoping that nothing happens and making sure that nothing happens. So it's this role that we have, we're just constantly watching them, but we're not really understanding them, like what they're doing. And once they leave the shelter, we don't follow them, so we have no idea what their life is like outside the shelter. We have, we're not really, well, as a worker, I wasn't their case manager, so we do get to take a look at some of their case history, like what their life's been like and, you know, how they are. So we do get some of that, but like we don't really fully understand them still, as because we just see them as cases. We just have this like history and stacks and their medications that they take, or, you know, it's just a case load to them, to us. And we document, you know, the things that about the client on a computer database system. So in a way, we know the clients, but we don't really. And I think that's the biggest mistake in our judgment, is that we come to thinking that we know these clients. or know these people living in the shelter because we're with them for so long. Especially with a lot of the workers that I work with, we did a lot of hours. In some respects, I think I've been in the shelter more than I actually spent any time in my home. Sometimes, like, it'd be like, you know, I do a 16-hour shift, come home, sleep for like 3 hours or 4 hours, go back to the shelter, do 16-hour shift, come back home, like, sleep for 4 more hours, and then go back. So it's kind of like I'm there. It feels like I'm living more in the homeless shelter than actually in my own home. So in that sense, we feel like we know and we live with these shelters, homeless people, so much. And a lot of times what we see is people, like, even in the afternoon, we see these homeless people just kind of sit on their own beds and do nothing and just sleep late, just kind of, you know, eat, sleep. That's all we see, really. Eat, sleep, and just sit around and do nothing. So I think that's why a lot of times that our attitude as a worker, even though you would expect a worker to kind of be more accepting of the homeless, it's kind of gone the opposite direction a lot of the times. I personally sometimes had myself just kind of go like, oh my gosh, you know, like, I could be sleeping, but I'm doing a 16-hour shift and just watching these guys sleep in front of me, you know, and being lazy in front of me. So that's one thing also. And just one thing I've noticed about, the one thing I've really learned from my experience, one of the biggest changes in my attitude is the whole system of homeless care, the whole bureaucracy. I knew going in that I was kind of not going to be fond of it, but now that I kind of understand it more, I am definitely more cynical than I ever was about social services than before. I mean, there's a lot of good that we do, especially in New York City, because service for homeless people is like one of the greatest in the country, which says a lot about how crappy our homeless situation is in the country, but it's the greatest, one of the greatest in the country. And so seeing that, I mean, there's a lot of great things I see about the work that the anti-homeless organizations do, like shelters and such. But it's a cyclical thing. These organizations, it's funny how even in nonprofits, it's always about the money. And seeing how that money is kept in circulation, that's kind of been the most cynical thing for me to see. As far as my attitudes toward the homeless people themselves, unfortunately, I feel like I haven't learned or experienced them as much as I would have liked to throughout this experience. I've had some really great conversations with homeless people. I've seen a lot of crazy negative things that kind of, you know, but I still hold to this belief that everyone is an individual. And, you know, it whether you're homeless or whether you become homeless, I mean, it's a case-by-case basis. It's always different. We can't come to be like, I'm working here, I see these people, I know them now, and start making judgments. And it's so easy to do, but that's still something I've always tried to fight against. And I've always been kind of, I've been disappointed seeing that happen a lot of times, a lot more so from people working in the shelter whose job it is to serve the homeless people, come to have like these judgments and stuff. It's not easy, you know, to not have them. I mean, I've been guilty of it too, because like I said, our role makes that so easy to happen, because we get to thinking like we're here to helping the homeless, and then they're causing all this problem. You know, they're cussing at us, they're talking bad about us and behind our backs. There's all these problems. Some people just never listen to us. You know, it's just, there's this mentality like we're doing so much, yet they're rejecting so much, and just gets down on us, and it's stressful. And then our bosses make that even tougher, you know. So I think that's part of the reason why our attitude has become so, you know, and that's how people in this sector or people in this field become jaded. And I could totally understand why or how now that people come into this field hoping to do great work, hoping to, you know, like, bring a lot of empathy and be passionate, and then kind of just fizzle out and just become this, like, just apathetic and indifferent kind of person who's just kind of like, I hate people. You know, I can totally see how or why that happens. It's actually only a very fraction, small fraction of the workers that happens, but it happens so dramatically that once you see that, it's kind of very disheartening. And it was very disheartening for me seeing that bits and pieces here and there from different people, you know, and that's just a year. For me, and a lot of the people that I work with were fairly new to working at a shelter, and it's surprising because one of my biggest inspiration, like one of my biggest co-worker that I got so much inspiration from, and that person worked in the shelter system for over 15 years, and she still had this incredible amount of passion and knowledge and empathy for the clients or for the homeless people in the shelter that, like, I was like, wow, so this person can work here this long for this position and still have this kind of drive and passion to understand these people and not feel like you already understand. Because I think the moment we start going like, I understand these homeless people, the moment we think that, it's game over. That's when you start becoming jaded. Because you don't. You won't. And I think our goal should be to, people working for the homeless people, I think our goal should be to understand an individual as much as possible, to help them as best as possible, to help them reach their biggest potential as much as possible. But then we shouldn't ever become so arrogant to think that we do understand. You know, I think the moment that we do, that's a problem. Because once we do that, then we start going, okay, I understand this guy, but why is he doing this? This is not right. This guy is being lazy. This guy is not listening. This guy should be doing this instead of that. The moment that we put judgment and like the like that kind of thing into it, it kind of ruins us, I think. And that's when we start having this attitude like, you know, I've done all I can and this is what's happening. Like, this is all I get. Fine. Fuck it. I give up. This is you're on your own. And I think that's when that attitude starts happening. And I haven't seen that extreme degree happen in my former coworkers. But I've seen like hints of moving towards that direction, and it always terrified me. It always scared me. Like, could I end up having that kind of thoughts too? You know, and that's just kind of some of my observations, I think, that this assumption that just because, I've had this assumption that like, hey, we work in a shelter. We help the homeless people, so clearly, you know, it helps us connect better to the homeless people, but sometimes that's not necessarily the case. Sometimes people who barely know about homeless people at all kind of have a little bit more curiosity and maybe understanding towards clients than people who pretty much lived and worked with homeless people for years, I think. And I think that's kind of an interesting thing to observe for me. But that's really all I have to say in this video.